Even his member in his family do not like to stay in market. They do sold out their possessions. Say with the decree of the Lord. Because I am touched in my heart tonight. And the God that caused you to sell off your possessions. I cause that power tonight.
May
this power set your life free. Say it aloud. I will never turn desolate. Say it aloud. I will never turn desolate. Listen, beloved. Many people cover some of their souls as cursed dead. In our branch at Lagos, I met a certain woman with a child, and she had 11 husbands. People just put her brought that to me, say she had good character, even more than them. And where I tried to pray, the Lord asked me to ask her how many husbands her mother reached before she stopped. And she said she's only one in her mother's hand, and her mother paraded 7 husbands' house. And I quickly understood when mother tried 7 man's houses, then it will be multiplied by 2.
Then
after I decree that it is enough for you to stay in 11 man's matrimonial house. I do not joke. The power that play your life like a card. I'm pushing you up and down. May this power stop walking over your life.
But you will Proverbs 26:5.
Proverbs 26:5.
Things are falling.
Proverbs 26:2. As the bird by wandering, as swallowed by flying, so the causeless shall not come. And listen, beloved, there are some five people, when they call someone, and that cause will stick to that people. Either man sin or not is immaterial. For these people have been given the power.
But any
listen, beloved. If you do anything that is irritating, and if that person curses you, beloved, that curse will stick to that person's life. And that is why I met a reverend. God said I should tell him that he's making use of him, but he will never have rapture. In fact, I'm scared. I don't know what to tell him the news. Then what about all the things I've been doing? I said, Lord, what is happening? The Lord asked me to inquire from him. During the time he was in service. And the Lord said that woman or lady has a child now.
It
doesn't see that lady and the mother for past years. Now this lady now cursed.
Say
someone that impregnated her. And he told God, if at all you allow people to come to rest in your abode, never allow him to come into you. Thereafter, I told Reverend, now go and search for this lady. Without this, you may not be rapturable when God comes. Raise your 2 hands.
Baba Mio!
My Father. I pity some airlines here tonight. Is that the way my Father, rescue me from the cause that you will kill me.
Jesus.
Oh, look at Jesus.
Oh, yeah, Tony, that's what you are.
Jesus' name we pray.
And
the second person
is
someone that you deliberately punish. And if that person curse one God's life, and that God will stick. Like a sister that sent a man to school.
He sent him to university at a polytechnic level.
And by the time this man will graduate out of the school, he said, this lady is too short for her liking. I said, she's too short. Every time I send my money meant for my food to you, you do not say or make any complaint. And thereafter, she now invoke curse on
him.
Let no woman dwell in your habit. I want you, beloved. Disclose some secret to me when we pray that I told her to tell me the truth. And a certain man sent her to school. And by the time she graduated out of the school, and she told that man, you have what head? And that one told her, by the time you are spending my money, you never alter anything. Is that the way you want to overturn things now? And he cursed her. And that cause sticks to her life. And
for
a number of years, he carried the pregnancy without being delivered. That he has for
number
her
three
husband. Anybody just try to make use of him or her. You take the advantage of his weakness and you capitalize on it. And when he or she curses your life, and that curse will stick to your life. That is why it is very awful to a prophet that sleeps with the members. Because he's making use of the opportunity that lady, she's a member or a sheep. And he has warned her if he tried to leak out the secret, he will go insane. And when that lady calls him, and that cause will stick to that prophet or pastor. Whosoever that you cheat on this earth, so you that are here that you have raped a lady one way or the other, you need to repent and pray seriously. And one of our members came to me and she said her daughter was raped in the school. I was so furious. I said, Lord, let these five boys that did this atrocity take away their peace. I said, wow, what a little sister. And the Lord told me I will never take vengeance on them. Ask the father of that daughter.
20 years ago, near Eyini High School.
A couple of 20 years ago in Eyini High School. On Wednesday like this,
there are
five of them raped a particular sister.
So, 20 years,
exactly 20 years.
I
room for another five young able boys so they can be able to sleep with his daughter.
No, it's okay.
Raise your two hands.
You
seal of anger.
No problem.
I feel that for you to say you will not pray here, but see you alone. You seal of anger.
They're
coming all the way from my father. You cannot touch my head. Turn away.
In the name of Jesus.
Oruko Jesu.
Yes.
You pray. Be seated, Lord.
Number four.
If you engage in any fight with your parents, and if they curse you, it will stick to your life. There's no wisdom in this. And my father is not a Christian, it is immaterial. Money in the night, when it costs you, it will be so. And that is why, beloved,
Genesis 49 verse 1 to 3,
Jacob invoked curse on Reuben.
He had a last work
on my hand. I said, to be like water, because you defied my count. You will never excel.
And
on the spot, that cause sticks to his life. Go and beg your father and your mother. If I told their inner spirit, you can dwell with them in your wisdom. That's why the Bible says if you are walking carnally, we do not wage war. And our spiritual warfare is not
carnally,
but mighty through God to the pulling down of the strongholds. If your mother is a witch and do not dwell with her with the wisdom, she will end up your life. If at all you want to win her, you must buy her a provision. Don't give her money, because if they take your money into their coven, it is possible for you to be stagnated. So if you have the money, use your money to buy a provision. The Bible says, feed your enemies. Give them what to eat and what to drink. And via these, you are even call of fire on them.
So
if they are eating your food and they are trying to kill you, they are trying to wound themselves.
Because
never give her your money. If you give her and they feel you eating with money, it can affect you. Have holiness. Because if they curse you, it will stick to your life. Here lies an astounding problem.
Jeremiah
told a particular man called Pastor, an understanding prophet of the Lord. And Pastor deliberately named him.
Jeremiah
told Pastor, Jeremiah chapter 20,
verse 2 to 5.
Say, you are Pastor, your name is goodness surrounds you. But you shall no longer be called that name. Mago Mizabub, meaning that trouble will surround your life. And ever since that time, that call sticks to his life. Beware of a prophet. Be friendly with him and never be quarrel with him. The anger just at once, he can lock the door against you. Here lies an outstanding problem. And if you now find yourself under this curse and do not repent, and this curse of these people can ruin your life. There are some cars that make use of 1 hour in vain and cost 1 hour to palace. And there are some cars that do kills.
And
to observe all these causes, problem or understand a problem will emerge in your life. In Genesis chapter 30, and the Bible says, Laban, he began to pursue after Jacob.
Sorry, Genesis 31. And when
that Jacob, and when I met him, he told Jacob, what you have done is very terrible. He did not wait until I send you off to run away. And Jacob said, just because I feared you, then I ran away. And
he
now told Jacob, if I thought you ran away, what about my idol that you took away along with
you? Genesis 31 verse 32. Jacob,
and Jacob said, he doesn't carry his idol.
And
he said, with whomsoever thou findest that God, let him not leave. And Jacob and Laban departed. But at Genesis 35,
verse 16 to 18,
verse 16 to 18. And the Bible says they are about to reach Ephraim. And the meaning of Ephraim is the city of success. And Rachel began to travail. And the midwife told her that you will deliver this baby without knowing. And that the mobile cars is moving upon her. And that try concerning Rachel. So this power stand on her that you must die. Because you are the one that took the girl along with you. And you must not go. It's not good for you to be alive. And the Bible says, as Rachel was dying, and the baby is coming out of her body. And she called that name Bion. But the father turned it again.
Benjamin,
it shall be called Benjamin, a child that will cause me to be delighted.
For
that cause killed Rachel. I would like to pray. If you see any mobile cause moving in the atmosphere,
that
kill your household member, both physical and spiritual. May this cause be averted. Say it aloud. Be averted. Say it aloud. Say it aloud very well.
Bible is on the way Joshua 6.
Bible talks in Joshua chapter 6.
Joshua with Jericho.
And Bible say, talks about after Joshua pulled down the wall of Jericho.
Joshua said, draw lori Jericho to
war. And Joshua stood on the fence, he broke. And he cursed the city. And Joshua calls at that time.
Then Joshua 6 verse 26.
Joshua 6:26. So curse be unto that man in the presence of the womb, the Lord will rise. That will build up this city again. With the death of his person, will he use to lay the foundation? And with the death of his last born, will he use to build the gate of the city?
But First Kings 16.
But the Bible says in First Kings 16,
verse 34.
And a young man rose suddenly that we build the city. Without knowing that cause that do kill is moving or hovering in the family. And the Bible says, as he was building that fence, he used his first son to lay the foundation and used the last born to build it up.
First Kings 16 verse 34.
In the day of Eli, that man built Jericho and he laid the foundation in the name of his first son. And he built up the second gate. And we say go with the last burn. As the word of the Lord.
That
came forth to Joshua the son of
Nun.
This man did not know.
Oh, they know fair share Jericho.
He wanted to do good in the land of Jericho. I do not deny you not to do good to your members, but just for
equality.
It may be the cause that kills still roaring in the firmament. A man came from US. He was saying to me to come and meet me. And as I was praying, and he was trying to move out. And I quickly said to him, go and call him back. I told him, where do you go? He said, he's going toward the Kiti town. And I told him, I saw your coffee. Want you to go to your town till you leave. And he said, prophet, this one is impossible. My mother is there. And his kingdom was
for years.
He has slept out for years. And I told this young man, please don't toy with this prophecy. And the dead ones do not know things going on behind him. Don't go or step into your town. Believe me, you rebuffed. And the second person told me when he got to the town,
I want to follow a
man money.
5,000.
And the least money he spent is 5,000 individual. Say, go and spend this.
Ashejire,
and he was killed in the Ashejire water. Look here, beloved. This man never knew that the cause that killed moving or over in the town.
wall.
And seeing, let me build the fence that broke in this city.
But in Ryan, at gravel.
As he was buying sand and gravel.
So the foundation.
And wanted to do the foundation.
So
and he had in the house and the husband died. Does he know?
To continue.
He said, continue building the fence.
And
the very day that we round up the assignment and build the gate. And what the Bible says.
From number one.
Right from the first one, all his children, he used them to build the fence. Because of the cause that kills, is offering in the family. Beloved, I will want you to pray. Many of us will not die physically, but in our finances, we are
dead.
Many of us do no longer carry anything anymore. And some people's spiritual life has been killed via the cause that do kill and the one that do fly in the heaven in the, of their family. Some people's marriage has been totally killed. Some people's career has been totally killed. Some people's ministry has been totally killed. Some people's work has been totally killed via the cause that do kill. Beloved, I will charge you to pray. So many persons were found dead now. Some people's help have been found dead. Some people's location that was to be in abroad has been killed. They were found roaming about on the spot. Tonight's the night we all need to pray. All our household members that need to be a link to the world has been cut off suddenly. In some people's family, only people that are proper, they are the one remaining. And these powers has cost a lot of honor down. And without deceiving you, beloved, many heads that needs to give out, they were done to be a beggar. And the mind of cause that do kill is very terrible. You may be thinking, saying, is it Akinima is saying, I'm too much alive. Many, we have many living
cadavers.
You may not be killed on time because Holy Spirit has been used to be the seal of your life. But when one destiny is being killed, he has nothing to offer this world anymore. Realize the deep mystery. There is a particular cause in Levi's family. He killed Moses into this world. He denied him to get into the land promised. As much as he can pray, he
died
because that do kills his offering on his life.
So
he must be unto the anger of Levi. And Simeon, my soul do not align with
them.
My spirit do not mingle in their tent.
They shall
be scattered in the midst of Israel. Moses never knew this. He was working until this cause finished his destiny. I would like you to pray here tonight. There is a terrible curse, beloved, in the family of Manasseh. As Gideon was so great, that cause pulled him down. In Judges chapter 9, Gideon later came to worship God. Realize and understand the matter. I would like you to pray, beloved. What is this cause that do kill?
Number one,
and the first cause that do kill is the cause of those that are weak.
But if I
and the cause of those that are weak, we cause one life to be totally wrecked. If you turn deaf or be blind to this, okay, if you cheat the deaf and blind and you cheat on them, believe me, and they brought here a
person.
And to the answer the prophet took him, he cheated on her and impregnated her. And now has for paper to write something down. He wrote down curse. Say whosoever that curse had to be like this, that his child or children will never know peace. Realize, understand the problem.
Pastor,
Reverend Amaho, all his family members, they are all dying. About eight of them remaining just him alone.
Age 39 to 40.
Now they do not die
in their longevity for an age of 38, they do not grow.
So, 38.
When he's getting to 38 years,
he
and he has started.